operation of the machine becomes so odious, makes you so sick at heart, that you can't take part, you can't even passively take part, and you've got to put your bodies upon the gears and upon the wheels, upon the levers, by all the apparatus, and you've got to make it stop, and you've got to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all.
This Schapelle Corby film that's just come out, Schapelle Corby should be the word on everyone's lips at the moment. And if people out there listening haven't seen the film, it's called Expendable. You can go to expendable.tv online and you can stream it from there. Every Australian needs to see this film. Watch it, download it, burn copies, give it out to people, do letterbox drops, drop it into shopkeepers, drop it into everybody. I'm going to drop one in every shop and I'm going to go and put a bunch of them on the desk of the police station with a little note saying, just in case you guys ever feel like actually doing your job. And the question on everybody's lips should be, why is little Howard Magoo, Alexander Downer, and Mick Keelty, the Commissioner of Australian Federal Police, not in jail? They should be taken to Bali. They should be put in Schapelle Corby's cell and left there to rot. And Schapelle should be brought home. You know, the utter corruption of the Australian government, of the ABC Broadcasting Commission and the Australian Federal Police Force is absolutely shocking, mate. You've got a bunch of sociopaths that sit there in Canberra. They write rules on pieces of paper and they call it law and they use it to steal everything they can from everybody and to victimise and brutalise the population of this country. They give the police the monopoly on violence. It's absolutely ridiculous, and the people of this country have to stand up and do something about it, because this country's been stolen from us. It's been run by criminals. The absolute corruption at the highest levels of this government and the highest levels of our police force, we have to do something about it. Schapelle's in a lot of danger. She's going to die in jail if she doesn't get let out, and she's completely innocent. And anybody out there who thinks she isn't, I highly recommend you go and watch this movie, because she's completely innocent. Mm. And so they've done a rush job on it to get it out, and good on them. But if you can get over the poor quality of the production, once you get 10 minutes or 15 minutes into the film, it starts bringing you in, and the information that it presents you is absolutely astounding. It's jaw-dropping information, and it shows so clearly the corruption that exists in this country. And the only people who are going to be able to deal with this is the people themselves. I mean, we have to stand up and hold our public servants accountable for their actions, because even in the preamble to the Australian Constitution, it says that the people of Australia are the government of Australia. We hold all the cards. We have the ability to hold our government to accountability, and we need to do it. And it doesn't matter what legislation they've enacted, because the only law in this land is the constitution of this country. And that can't be changed except by the people themselves.
What was the most thing that sort of you saw, like just opened the book up about Schapelle Corby?
The information that came through about the boogie board bag and the weight of her luggage. The weight of her luggage weighed 5 kilos more when it came to Bali than what it, when it went through the check-in. So therefore the bag, the luggage was tampered with. They didn't produce that in the trial.
Mm.
But the weight results show that the bag was interfered with while it was behind the scenes. And that is huge. That is absolutely huge. Plus, the boogie board bag is missing. Now, there's no record of it. Once it goes through past that counter, there's no record of it until it gets to Bali. All the other luggage, there's data on all this luggage, but there's no data on that bag.
Mm.
So that bag was treated differently behind the scenes. And so that shows, that it clearly shows, that it was tampered with, plus the weight of the luggage, 5 kilos over. And then when you see the efforts the government and the ABC and the Australian Federal Police went to, the Australian government not only ignored the evidence, but ensured that this young woman would be convicted, because a verdict of innocent would have caused an investigation into the drug running that happens at Australian airports, with which the Australian Federal Police are very likely heavily involved. We believe are the protectors of society. They're just basically a criminal gang who have a monopoly on violence. That's all the Australian police are. And we need to wake up to what's going on here, because we're being shafted by these people. And what we have to do is peaceful non-compliance. We can't have violent revolution We need peaceful non-compliance, and we need to understand that we, the people of Australia, are the law, we are the government, we are Australia. We are the nation of Australia, and the government are our employees. They are acting in breach of trust, and they're getting away with it because we're sitting on our asses and watching television and drinking beer while everything that is Australia is being removed from us by these psychotic lunatics that currently inhabit Canberra.
And it, look, we're doing petitions. Now, does that do anything, you reckon?
Doesn't do a damn thing. Signing a petition tells the government what you think they should do. They don't have to do any of it. You sign a people's mandate. We, the people of this country, hereby mandate that you do the following. If you fail to do so, you've abdicated your right to govern and you will be replaced. This is our will. You know, and if you want to have anything major, you want to have a carbon tax, we demand a referendum. You want to put body scanners in airports, we demand a referendum. Anything that you are going to do that you call law is not law unless it's approved by the Australian people. Screw all your legislation. It's just a bunch of rubbish. It's a bunch of lines written on pieces of paper. None of it has been done with the permission of the Australian people. We hold all the cards. Do what we say or you can step down. It's as simple as that. And the only reason this doesn't happen is because the Australian people are too apathetic to stand up and make it happen. So get up off your ass, folks, because you need to do this, because all you're doing is freeloading on your grandkids. Now, we are the custodians of freedom in this country. Every generation are the custodians of freedom. And all the government does is remove that freedom from us. And they've been massively successful at it since they introduced television and they regulated the newspapers. This is what has done it. This is what's done it, folks. So it's about time we read the writing on the wall and stood up and put things back to the way they should be. We really have to make some noise about Schapelle Corby. I want everybody out there who is able to do so to download a copy of Expendable from expendable.tv and send DVDs to all the police stations in your area, send DVDs to any lawyers that you know. If you know of any Queen's Councils or you know the addresses of any Queen's Councils in Australia, send them a DVD. Send a DVD to the Office of the Prime Minister of Australia and ask her straight out if she intends to fix this problem and get Schapelle released, or should we, the people, look at holding her as being complicit in the future when we take John Howard and Alexander Downer and Mick Keelty to trial. And make it clear, folks, tell them that this is what we intend to do, because the information contained within this film has caused we, the people of Australia, to become aware of the immediate need to reinstate the constitution of our country, and because we have the right to do this, it is what we intend to do. So you need to decide which side you are on right now. Say that to Julia Gillard when you write to her, folks, and ask her straight out whether she stands for Australia or whether she stands for the corporate corruption that put Schapelle Corby in the position that she's in. Because frankly, it's either one or the other. And make a lot of noise about it. Send it to all the radio stations, send it to all the TV stations, send it to everybody you can. Let's flood Australia. Let's flood the offices of politicians. Let's flood the supermarkets, let's flood the towns, flood the shops, and flood the entire country with copies of this DVD. Get it out to everybody that you can, send it to all the newspapers in your area. Do everything you can to get this information into the hands of every single Australian, because this information can be used not only to secure the immediate release of Schapelle Corby, but it can bring down the criminality that exists within the Australian Federal Police and the Australian Federal Government. Once this government and this Federal Police Force are exposed as the criminals that they are, we will finally be able to have some freedom and some justice in this country. And what we're being presented with here is an opportunity to achieve this. And this is one of the most important moments of Australian history. It really is, folks, because now is the time that we can choose to be free, because with the release of this film and the support of the community, we finally have the means with which to not only save the life of a young woman wrongly incarcerated for a crime she did not commit, but to expose the criminality within government for what it is, and to secure the freedom which is our birthright and which has been kept from us by those people that we employ to protect us.
I don't have to tell you things are bad. Everybody knows things are bad. It's a depression.
Everybody's out of work or scared of losing their job. The dollar buys a nickel's worth. Banks are going bust. Shopkeepers keep a gun under the counter. Punks are running wild in the street. There's nobody anywhere who seems to know what to do, and there's no end to it. We know the air is unfit to breathe. Our food is unfit to eat. Watching our TVs while some local newscaster tells us that today we had 15 homicides and 63 violent crimes, as if that's the way it's supposed to be. We know things are bad, worse than bad. I don't want you to protest, I don't want you to ride, I don't want you to write to your congressman because I wouldn't know what to tell you to write. I don't know what to do about the depression and the inflation and the Russians and the crime in the street. All I know is that first, you've got to get mad. You've got to say, I'm a human being, God damn it! My life has value!
I'm a human being, my life has value. I'm a human being, God damn it. I'm a human being, my life has value. I'm a human being, God damn it. I'm a human being, my life has value. I'm a human being, God damn it. I'm a human being, my life has value. I'm a human being, God damn it. You know I'm mad as hell, and I'm not gonna take it. Under this spell, but I managed to break it. Glued to the tube, now I finally escaped it. Take a hold of my fate, gonna claim it and shape it. With no hesitation, move the foundation. Like a tectonic plate, I'm here to shake up the nation. Awaken the sheep, we'll resurrect every people. Unveil every truth, and expose every evil. Another upheaval, revolution of the mind. Evolution of the spirit, liberty for humankind. Giving sight to the blind, strength to the weak. Every time I speak, they wanna see me 6 feet deep. But I don't give a fuck when it comes to pass. Bury me face down so they can kiss my ass. In a world of glass, I'm the brick breaking the planet.
I'm a human being,
God damn it. I'm a human being, my life has value. I'm a human being, God damn it. I'm a human being, my life has value. I'm a human being, God damn it. I'm a human being, my life has value. I'm a human being, God damn it. I'm a human being, my life has value. I'm a human being, God damn it.
Take a step to the left, now move to the right. But we're just running in circles if we don't unite. Stand up and fight, put away false pride. Free your mind from this left-right paradigm. I remember the day when I first woke up. Took a look at those towers, said, what the fuck? I know buildings don't fall at free fall speed. But then it all became clear, thermite at the scene. Dumping fluoride in the water, mercury and vaccines. Bringing down the IQs of every human being. It's destruction by design, the fall of mankind. Problem, reaction, solution every time.
I'm a human being, my life has value. I'm a human being, God damn it. I'm a human being, my life has value. I'm a human being, God damn it. I'm a human being, my life has value. I'm a human being, God damn it. I'm a human being, my life has value. I'm a human being, God damn it.
I want you to get up now. I want all of you to get up out of your chairs. I want you to get up right now and go to the window, open it, and stick your head out and yell, I'm as mad as hell, and I'm not going to take this anymore!
Damn it.